All right, here we go. Done. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Can you hear me back there?
Nope.
All right. On behalf of the Bright Room, I'd like to thank everybody for being here today. I'd really like to thank the family and friends that came from long distances away. Bill and Joanne Dial from Montana. We have the Dersham clan down from Wisconsin. Grandma Wilkerson from coming up from Florida. Thank you all for being here. For those of you who don't know me, my name's Scott. I'm Dave's only brother. And it's only taken him 35 years to admit that I'm the best man. He finally admitted it, so. And trust me, I've been where everybody's been sitting, and I know what you're all thinking. I hope this guy doesn't take forever so he can open up the bar. Well, at least I know this side of the room is definitely thinking that. But I promise I won't be long, because we came here to celebrate David Lindy's special day. Last thing you guys want to hear is me talking and rambling on about a story when you were younger and he was 10 years old and accidentally brought his underwear that had his name into it in the church. And I got the mic, I can make anything up I want. So, now this day definitely belongs to Dave and Lindy, and what a beautiful day it was, in fact. You know, beautiful weather, beautiful church, and now this amazing venue. Really is truly a beautiful day. Today is not only a celebration of life, but coming together of two people. Two people that found themselves as individuals this morning and are now one this evening. Nothing means more to me than my brother's happiness. And when I see him up here completely in love with you, Lindy, it means a lot to my family and me, myself. It makes me very happy. And I hope nothing but the best for you guys in your new adventure in marriage. So without further ado, please raise your glasses for the two people for which we are truly here today. All right, without them, this day wouldn't happen and we wouldn't be gathered here. To the bartenders. Oh, that's right, sorry. That's not why we're here, I guess. Okay. All right, all kidding aside, I'd like to wish the newly married couple my best. Marriage is not easy at all times, all right? And it requires work. But when two people love each other and are committed, anything is possible. And work on their, cherish the good times and work on the rough times. Because trust me, when you just married a Lang, there's going to be plenty of rough times. Oh, am I lying now? So are you? I'm not saying, I'm just saying. And I did what any best man would do. Went on Google and tried to find the best man speech, but I couldn't find one, so I had to make one up. So here it goes. All right. For real this time, please raise your glasses to Dave and Lindy. Remember to love, laugh, and cherish each other. Life is truly short, and I hope you enjoy yours together. Cheers. All right, how about a nice hand for our best man? We're the brother of the bride, so put your hands together for Ross Hennig.
Everyone, thank you. For those who don't know me, I'm Lindy's favorite brother. First of all, I want to say, Lindy, I'm truly honored to be the one that you chose to walk you down the aisle and give you away. Lord knows I've been trying to give you away for a while now. On behalf of our family, I want to start by thanking everyone for coming to celebrate and giving your blessings to my little sister and her new groom. It is amazing that you all drove such a long way out here to Rockton. Some of you flew, I'm sure that many of you plan to recoup most, if not all, your trail expenses through the open bar tonight. I am so glad that the wedding is finally here. I don't think I can take hearing about one more wedding discussion between my wife, mother, and sister about centerpieces and wood slices. Or have Wendy call us practically in the middle of the night, insisting that she come over to show us her 199th hair trial. I still cannot believe my little sister is actually getting married. It seems just like yesterday, you were running and playing around the ice rink while watching me during my hockey games and practices. I've watched you grow up from being my annoying little sister into an amazing therapist and woman. Though you know you all have to be my annoying little sister. Lindy, we've been through a lot over the years, some good, some bad, but I'll never forget some of the great memories we've shared together throughout the way. For instance, remember that 4th of July weekend during our Colorado trip? When we were up in the mountains watching the fireworks below us, wearing garbage bags as coats and underwear on our beds, to keep warm before Mom's on his way up a random stranger who stopped by with a fire truck, claiming that he was offering free rides to the kids. I'm pretty sure she was trying to get rid of us then. All kidding aside, I can't tell you how happy I am for the two of you. Dave, I have to admit, I was also a little skeptical when Lenny said she met you online and how you lived overseas. But the first time she brought you around, you actually said we've been good friends ever since our whole lives. And after getting to know you over the last few years, I can tell you are definitely the one for her. Someone that can make her laugh and understands if and when she gets moody. But more importantly, someone that I know will protect her and love her through whatever life may bring. As you two start this new journey together, there'll be good times and always bad times. But always remember that you always be there for each other when no one else will. So always remember, don't go to bed mad. Don't ever stop dating each other. And what many very, very smart people have said to me before today, and what Dave and every other married guy always finds out soon enough, happy wife, happy life. Now I'd like you all to join me, raise your glasses, and join me in toasting the new couple. Thanks, May. May you be blessed with many kids as you fight, or at least take ours for a while. And may you always love, honor, and cherish each other just as you do today. Woo!